There is a quick announcement, friends. Geography Notes has been uploaded recently in the Instamojo website, and you can find it in the description box. There is a link given below, and we have covered almost 25 topics, and the topics are physical setting of India, physiography of India, river system, cities and banks of the rivers, hydropower projects, mountains, peaks, forests, soils, climates and minerals available, and the list of national parks. There are almost 104 national parks, UNESCO World Heritage Center, Biosphere Reserves in India, croppings, cropping patterns, all about Indian railways, national waterways, international airports, and also we have covered physical geography, universe, earth, atmosphere, internal structure of earth, types of rocks, earthquakes and volcanoes, friends. If you haven't downloaded this, you have to download, friends. It is very very useful for you in your preparation. If you go to the description box, you can find the link over there and you can download the geography notes. Let's get into the topic. Hello friends, how are you? Welcome to Sunil Engineering Academy. This is Bharat and we are looking into geography series of lectures. And this class we are going to see national waterways in India. Why we have to concentrate on a national waterways? Because India has extensive network of inland waterways, that is through rivers, canals and backwaters and creeks, friends. The total navigable length that is identified by our government is 14,500 kilometers, out of which about 5,200 kilometers of the river and remaining 4,000 kilometers is of the canals, friends. These can be mechanized crafts, friends. If these are utilized properly, then we will have very good use of our national waterways. What is the importance for national waterways? Why waterways are needed? If we take, see friends, if you take London has many inland waterways and they have built artificially the canals and they made like streets of waters. See friends, because industrial revolution has happened first in London, and for the travel, for the transport of the goods and services and cargo, they have chosen waterways because it is the cheapest way to transport the goods and services. In airways, railways and roadways and waterways compared together, waterways is the cheapest one for the transport of goods. See friends, it takes around, if you calculate, it takes around 1 rupee 19 paise for 1 ton of freight for over 1 kilometer of journey, friends. That is, to transfer 1 ton of weight for over 1 kilometer, it just costs around 1 rupee and 20 paise, friends. For one, if you take in the terms of fuel, for 1 liter of fuel, water can carry 105 tons for over 1 kilometer, but a lorry or a roadway container can transfer or transport only 24 tons for 1 kilometer. From this you have to know that difference is very very huge if we opt to waterways. Besides having a big advantage for inland waterways, the other benefits of inland waterways are fuel efficient, cost effective and it is environmental friendly, friends. It reduces accidents, traffic and congestion on roads and railways. Obviously, if you have improved inland waterways, then most of the traffic is diverted to the waterways, and obviously there will be a decrease in the traffic on roads and railways. Thereby, accidents will also be reduced, friends. And our inland waterways has immense potential for domestic cargo, friends. And if you improve a new area or new department like inland waterways, and obviously there will be more and more opportunities and jobs in that field, friends. Investment and business opportunities is also improves, friends. So where is the potential for inland waterways? If we see here, India has large network of water bodies in the form of rivers, lakes, canals, backwaters. These long waterways provides a good mode of transport across the cities as well as towns like backwaters of Kerala, canals in Gujarat, and few waterways in Goa, West Bengal, and Assam. Still, these inland waterways are unutilized in India as compared to other countries in the world. If you go to Europe, friends, you can see all the Scandinavian countries and Poland, you can see London and other, they utilize waterways in an efficient manner. But India fails in this, friends. Waterways Authority of India is working on new projects for waterways and better water transportation in India, friends. If you see here, this is developed by National Waterways Authority of India. They have identified total length of 4,503 kilometers of potential waterways, and totally it covers 15 states, friends. From Allahabad to Haldia, you can see Haldia to Allahabad, you can see National Water One Way One, that is 1,620 kilometers. It covers the states given here: UP, Bihar, Jharkhand, and West Bengal. And National Waterways Two is on the Brahmaputra River, that is Dhubri to Sadia, friends, 891 kilometers. It covers Assam, West Bengal, Arunachal Pradesh, and Meghalaya. And you can see here the National Waterway 3 is in Kerala, that is West Coast Canal, Kollam to Kottapuram of 205 kilometers. And the National Waterway 4 is the combination of Godavari, Krishna, and canals, that is from Kakinada Port to Puducherry, friends. This is inland waterway. It's not on the bay. It's not on the Bay of Bengal, friends. It's inland waterway. Inland waterway, friends. Okay, it connects AP, Tamil Nadu, and Puducherry. And the third one is a Brahmani Delta Canal, that is Goenkale to Talcher of 588 kilometers in Odisha and West Bengal, friends. And the sixth one they have proposed is the sixth proposed National Waterway 6 is on the Barak River, that is Lakhipur to Banga. Here they have not given clearly the stretch. It stretches from Assam, Mizoram, Manipur, and Tripura, friends. So these are the waterways which has been identified. Not only benefits, but also there are many challenges in this national in the development of national waterways, friends. We have many dams constructed, and most of the southern Indian rivers are not perennial rivers but seasonal rivers, and gradually this water level comes down, and it will be very difficult for the cargoes and ships to move in the waterways, friends. So, given with the challenges, India is looking for the to exploit the full utilization of the resources of inland waterways. Along with inland waterways, we also have many number of ports. Out of these, there are majorly 13 seaports in India which is identified, friends. See here, you have Chennai Port, Haldia Port. In Mumbai, we have two ports, that is West Mumbai Port and South Mumbai Port, which is called Jawaharlal Nehru Port or Nhava Sheva Port, and Mumbai Port in West Mumbai. And from there, if we go down, we have Panjim Port in Goa, that is Marmagoa Port, and Panjim Port in Goa Port. And from there, if we go down, we have Mangalore Port. We have Mangalore Port, and then we have Kochi Port. From there, we have Tuticorin in Tamil Nadu, and Ennore Port in Tamil Nadu, Chennai Port in Tamil Nadu, and we have in Andhra Pradesh, we have Visakhapatnam Port, and from there, Paradip Port in Odisha, and Deen Dayal Port in Kandla, friends. So we have almost 13 ports which you have to remember at any cost. You have to remember at any cost, friends. So after this, inland waterways and ports, we have international airports in India. The list is given. The international, the, all the international airports is given, and that names are, you have to remember those names I have given here. That is of 25 international airports you can go through. And Siliguri, it is called Bagdogra Airport. Ahmedabad, it's Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Amritsar, Sar Guru Ram Das. In Bengaluru, its name's Kempegowda. Chennai, it is same. Cochin, it is same. Goa, it is same. Guwahati, we have Lokpriya Gopinath Bardolai. In Hyderabad, it is GMR Rajiv Gandhi International Airport. Kolkata, it is Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Mumbai, it is EC friends for the railway station and the airport. We have same name, that is Chhatrapati Simaji. In Delhi, it is Indira Gandhi. You have to remember, in Delhi it is Indira Gandhi, in Hyderabad it is Rajiv Gandhi. You have to remember in that way, friends. So in Thiruvananthapuram, it's same Port Blair, it's Veer Sarvarkar. Calicut, it's same Calicut or Kozhikode, it's the same name, friends. In Nagpur, it's Baba Saheb Ambedkar, B.R. Ambedkar, friends. Jaipur, it's the same. Lucknow, Chaudhary Charan Singh. Varanasi, it's Lal Bahadur Shastri. In Bhubaneswar, it's Biju Patnaik. In Vijayawada, it is NTR, NTR friends, Nandamuri Tarak Ramarao. And in Vishakhapatnam, it's the same. Dabolin Airport in Goa, it's the same. And Mangalore, it's same. Srinagar, it's Sheikh Ul Alam. And Ranchi, it is Birsa Munda Airport, friends. So you have to remember these names.